And now for something completely different. Well, I was thinking about lunch. Sometimes what's going to happen next. And maybe lunch is the most exciting thing there. And I thought gratitude. Fulfilling prophecy. Pretend I'm running water. And so I'm gonna get a pot on to boil. There. Because I think I want to put the kettle on as well. Something different and yet easy and with what I hadn't recovered. And sure enough, there's a solution. Meanwhile, the kettle screams to boil. Not making sounds like it is. It's not even if you can hear me. Or about this one, but just sort of like sorting laundry. Classics stand by. Only during 8 or possibly 8.5, 8.9 out of 10 Canadian and maybe American households, there's some 1 or 2 or 10 boxes of Kraft Dinner for occasions just like this. Or the generic alternatives or other alternatives. This one complements, which is, I believe, Safeway's brand and the deluxe white cheddar variant, which has become, as we all know, fairly popular. So for starters, maybe choose a different kind of mac and cheese. When you buy them, I look for the box white cheddar when they're on special, picking up the vegetables. Now, what else? We're going to need some ingredients, like some milk. And butter. Everyone knows that you need milk and butter or margarine to make Kraft Dinner. But why stop there? Why not have a couple of vegetables out of the fridge, see what you've got, and see what a difference it can make, just to liven things up a bit. While you're at it, for goodness sakes, kids, eat your fruit and vegetables. I mean, I'm going to try and put some in the meal here. I've got some old sort of spinach. But right now, at the moment, I'm hungry, so I've got some ripe bananas in the fridge. Why not? Simple, easy, inexpensive, really. But also, right? Vitamins, fiber, natural calories, natural fruit sugars, maybe just the sort of thing to get one over the hump.
pretty nice. Put that in the compost.
It's gonna go in the fridge for iced tea for later. Okay.
Okay then.
I have a little cup of tea while we're making lunch or with lunch. Possibly see how we get along here. Got our dog to make it in. Now we're gonna have to get up in no time, it's a steel pot. Pour that out into the mug. So we get both the teapot and our mug nice and warm. And we're just going to have some coffee on this tea, orange pico. That's gonna be tangy. What we wanna do with this is chop up our onion finely. Cut the top off. There we go. Now we've got finely chopped onions. Throwing up the bowl. And pour those in the bowl. For some sense, just pour it in the onions. Probably not working. Good. Onions. Now, I've got about a half of a little bit of green pepper here, about going a little dive.
Just in time, a lot of boiling. So we're going to get the salt. Pour in the pot and set the timer
for 8 minutes to check it down and give it a little stir about. Right. Those are going to be great with the macaroni, but I think like the onions, they need a little bit of cooking. Just, I think, a very light sauté. Not a sauté all day, just a sauté. And I think to get me there, good cup of get salon while macaroni is boiling. Give that another stir, make sure that it's still at the bottom. There we are. Okay, they are bubbling. So meantime, let's sauté our onions and our green peppers here. Got our pasta bowl and the drain pan for later. So I think we'll just saute these in a little bit of olive oil and some butter. There we go. A couple of tablespoons or tablespoon a bit of olive oil. About a tablespoon. About as much butter and oil as is needed. And you can't see, but I can see that the butter is bubbling, and you can hear it. And that's the water evaporating off or boiling off the butter. The water that's a part of the butter, which is the whey part, I guess. So as soon as, Mark, as soon as they stopped doing that, right away you can put the food in, or that butter will brown. would say as soon as or sooner. So there, put in my onions right away. That cools it down. And it's sizzling again. So you probably hear that sizzle. I'm almost stopped. Throw in and it's sizzling. This way the butter is reduced, and it's just the actual butter flavor and the fat, and that it's a direct contact with the food with the stir, saute, stir fry, and just a little expert tip there, a little pointer, to provide a little more satisfying result, possibly. Salt at the end of the day, and we've got some rather wilty spinach. So yeah, quite kind of wilty. I'm gonna have to give this a rinse and see what we've got left. Okay, so after I've got those rinsed out and sorted, there's a few discarded in the sink, and I'm just going to set this aside here and deal with this in a moment. Stir up this slight saute. I don't really want to thoroughly throw the cookies, but I just want to dip it about one time. Like I want this method. I deliberately set the timer for only 8 minutes just so I could check on it and see. Because usually it takes about 9.
But you can't really go backwards with boiling.
We can reserve water, so we're gonna take a bowl, put that under the colander too. For in a minute, we're gonna drain our pasta. And we wanna do something to that operation that makes it more efficient and effective. Okay, there goes our timer for 8 minutes. So let's check. You know, I'm glad I set it for early because I think it's done enough. So there, I'm pouring that out into the colander. And now I think I just want some of that hot water back. Fortunately, I saved some of that hot water, and I'll put it back. There, and I think I'm just going to plop that spinach right. And it's still heated, and it's still heating, so it's going to boil in a second, and it'll be done. Meantime, I'm actually going to turn off my onions. I'm actually going to combine it with our pasta. Small, no small part, because one, I need to call you back for another purpose. Alright. Just stir that up a little bit. It's looking very nice. Alright. Colander back in the bowl in the sink. And spinach. Is now wilted, so we're going to pour it into the colander. That's just beautiful. There we go, and now I can liberate the pot back from the macaroni. Okay, now, there we go. So to complete the recipe, two tablespoons of margarine or butter, except we've already gone a bit fat from the olive oil, so we're going to be good. So I didn't quite add 2 tablespoons. And this looks amazing for Kraft Dinner. Okay. Now, meanwhile, I'm spinach drained here. Serving bowl here. So I drain those out. Add my macaroni. Top with fresh spinach and voilà.